Hello team, welcome to the Docker training, and in this particular lecture we are going to discuss about the Docker internal processing when we are executing the Docker run command. So let's start with. So we will see when we are executing the Docker container run command, what is internally is being processed with the Docker. So very first, Docker will look in the cache, image cache, for the image which we want to execute, right? So suppose we are executing a command docker run nginx. So nginx is the image which we want to run with the help of the Docker. So after this command, Docker first look into the image cache for that particular image. If that image is not available in the local, then Docker go to the Docker remote repository. By default, it is hub.docker.com, and download the latest version of the image. If you have provided the specific version of the image inside the command, then Docker will download that specific version of that particular image. If it's find the Docker image inside the image cache, then it will not go to the hub.docker.com and will not download the latest version or the specified version of that image, right? Now, after this, based on the image what it find, it will start a new container, right? So we have already seen all these things. Now, from the networking point of view, Docker gives a virtual IP on the private network inside the Docker engine on which that particular container will execute, right? So Docker internally will assign an IP to that particular container. So let's see. So here is my terminal and I'm inside my Docker machine. So I will execute a command docker container ls. Right? So here is the container, here is the image which it is executing, the command which Docker is executing and created 40 minutes ago, and the ports. By default, you can see inside the container it is running on IP 0.0.0.0, right? So basically Docker creates its own virtual private network and define a specific IP to every container, right? We will discuss all these things inside the coming lectures when we learn about the Docker networking concepts. Now we will discuss about the ports. So in our previous commands, we have published some ports. The first port was denoted the host machine port, and the second port was denoted the container ports. After that, Docker will open a port. Suppose we provided port 80 in the command, then it will open the port 80 on the host machine where the Docker engine is running and route all the traffic on the port 80 inside the containers, right? So there's two ports which Docker is using to run that particular nginx image. Because this is the architecture of the nginx, internally it will accept the traffic on port 80, and outside you can configure any port on which the traffic will route to the local container port 80. After that, it will start the container with the help of command cmd in the image docker file. So till now we have not discussed this particular stuff. When we learn about the docker file and docker image, then we will see how Docker will basically run the image with the help of the cmd inside the docker file, right? So that's all. This is all things which Docker is running or processing when we are executing the Docker nginx process and the Docker engine. Thank you. Thanks for your time. In the coming lecture, we'll see some more interesting stuff about the Docker.